Heyo guys, BraverLeonheart here and welcome to episode number 30 of our Pokemon Platinum Randomizer Taglocke Challenge. We've reached a big 3-0. If you missed episode number 29, it is over on Chatty Chatot's channel. Please go and give it a watch because she took on the 7th badge, the 7th gym leader, and obviously she obtained it and informed me that she's had one death, which... You know what? One death in a gym is fine. You can't beat Snowpoint Gym's crystal. There you go. Used the PC box several times. Let's have a look what we've got. What happened? No, hang on. We don't need to go into the PC. I want to look at the party. Where did that sizzle come from? Is that the egg hatch? That's the egg hatch. Oh, we got a Sizzle. Okay then. Right. And we got Pingu in the party as well. So we lost Eco. Eco's the one that went down in the last episode. That stinks a bit. Eco is good. We've got hedgerows, though, so losing Eco is not the end of the world because we've already got a grass type. We've lost the ground type now, though, and it's been replaced. So we've got two steel types, but then... Well, it will be a steel type, Pingu will. But then Mantis is bug steel, so it's a perfect replacement for... And it's a good replacement for... Piney. So we've got Bullet Punch, Quick Attack, Full Swipe, and Focus Energy. So Full Swipe can help us catch things later on. Bubble Beam, Surf, Fury Attack, and Brine on Pingu. Oh, no, Citrus Berry, okay. Only level 40, Psychic Cut, Ice Punch, Slash, and Sword Stance. Nothing new there. Hedgerow's level 41, Charge Beam, Magical Leaf, Leap Seed, and Sky Upcut. Ashy's level 44 with Lava Plume, Flamethrower, Strength, and Quick Attack. Birdie Pie, Aerial Ace, Fly, Fury Attack and Assurance. What is he holding then? Leftovers. That's okay. I think that's what I put on him. So we want to just head in here for a second. I don't want to move items. That was wrong. Move Pokemon. So yeah, we lost Eco. That really sucks. Well, he's still level 39, so he didn't level up any. Alright. Fair enough. Part of the reason why this is a little bit disappointing is we now need to use Rock Climb. And we don't have Rock Climb on the party at the moment. So let's see. Ooh, we've got a TM for Zen Headbutt here. Anybody learn Zen Headbutt? We want Psycho Cut, don't we? Over Zen Headbutt. Can't see any other TMs that we've got. Okay, so we need to teach Rock Climb to somebody. Which sucks, because I don't really like Rock Climb, but... Oh, does it really have to go on Ashes? That stinks. Okay. Well, we've got Quick Attack that we can get rid of, but he's got Strength and Rock Climb now. So we can get rid of Quick Attack for Rock Climb, and then at the end of the episode, once we're done with Rock Climb, which I'm not sure we ever get done with Rock Climb, actually, you might need it in Victory Road. You got to put it on somebody, though. It has to go on somebody. So in today's episode, we need to go to the Acuity Lake from, I believe. Back there, apparently she didn't get to do any of that. So she says, I'm actually, this is a rare case where we've got three zap plates. It's a rare case where I'm actually recording before her episode has been uploaded. So I literally have no idea what she's done or what else has gone on. How do we get out of this city? Oh, we come from the bottom, don't we? There we go. So yeah, it's a rare case of me
actually not having a clue. Both missed this item. We got a blue shard, okay. Nothing worthwhile there. A great trainee recognised by the Pokemon League. So we're not recognised by the Pokemon League just yet. I'm really, really happy with that encounter, with that egg hatch. That's a really good egg hatch. To get a Scizor as well, because again, we can't trade. And I don't know if, because I set it so that trade evolutions will happen, but I don't know if that works. If I was to give a metal coat to a Scyther, would it evolve next level? I don't know if that works. So I'm kind of glad it must have just hatched as a Scizor. Unless you just use a metal coat on something. I don't know. I don't know how it works. I do think we have actually got a metal coat, I think, so might be worth at one point me train it out on something. Can we, what we got for Roost? We don't need Fury Attack. Roost might be useful. I'm gonna get rid of Fury Attack for Roost. There's no way. Fury Attack's not useful for anybody. She called it Mantis as well. Mantis is a great name. I like Mantis as a name. Mantis the Scizor. Come on. So we've got to head up here now. Rock climb our way up this hill. There's no way, yeah. Chatot's definitely not been up here. She must have spent the entire time in the gym last episode, which I'm pretty sure. Ooh, we got a shiny stone. Pretty sure the gym puzzle is like really dumb in Snowpoint City. So it's like I can understand her spending so long in there. Yeah, you're not gonna get away with. Oh, hang on. Oh, you're not gonna get away with this, Team Galactic.
Oh, are you finished already? Your Pokemon aren't bad, but you're laughably weak. You honestly thought you could save the Pokemon of the lake? Become the Pokemon champion? Dream on, little kid. But ew, it's so cold here. Let's get back to the Veilstone HQ. Oh, don't I know you? We met in Eterna City. Listen, Team Galactic is going to do something huge for everyone's sake. That's why you should keep out of Team Galactic's way. Don't come whining about poor Pokemon and other trivial junk like that. Don't waste your time coming to our HQ in Veilstone. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Yeah, that's right. I couldn't do anything against Team Galactic. That Pokemon called Uxie, it was suffering. I'm gonna get tougher. It's not about winning or losing. That ain't good enough. No, sirree. I gotta be stronger. And not just about wanting to be the most powerful trainer ever, either. I gotta take honest effort and a determined heart.
Alright. I don't know what I chat when he's on the screen. Right. She hinted. She said, "Don't you dare go to the Veilstone." Yeah, Veilstone. "Don't you dare go to Veilstone for to our HQ." So, Orberg, Eterni, Heartthome. Veilstone. I knew I'd find it eventually. Yeah, keep searching, you'll find it one day, aren't you? So I guess we're flying to Veilstone City, and we're going to see what havoc we can wreak in the HQ over here. In the darn HQ. Also, I forgot at the start of the episode, I forgot to apologise for the fact that there was only one episode last week on both channels. It is entirely my fault. Entirely my fault. For some reason, my laptop decided it was going to be real slow. Real slow. And I couldn't get it. Oh, I should have probably been reading this.
Hey, it's you! I bet you don't remember me, but I sure remember you. Because of you, they took my Clefairy away. My partner called it quits and went back to his old country. I know nothing. I don't know anything about any storage key.
Ah! You leave this to me. Storage key for entering the Teen Galactic Eye Out? I have it right here. But a frontal assault is not possible. We can enter that, but we can enter that hideout. Well, when you enter the hideout, you have your reasons, yes? Very well. Inside the Team Galactic warehouse, we'll meet there. Prepare the best you can. I shall join you shortly.
Okay. Do you just literally go in here? Is it literally just in here? Is it?
Raja, very well. Inside the Team Galactic warehouse, we will meet there.
Oh. It must be here then. Galactic Veilstone Building. I don't know. I really don't know. See, this is Galactic Veilstone Building. Cosmic Energy for the win. Cosmic Energy FTW. I guess there's not in here. I guess we've got to go and wander the streets a bit. To the warehouse. Maybe it's where... Yeah, maybe this dude went and found it. I don't know. I don't know. That's the game corner. I wish I could remember these things. It's been so long since I've played through 4th Gen. We can rock climb to get that item. I'm confused. We're gonna rock climb to get this item. We're gonna rock climb to get this. What is it? It better be something good now. I hope it's something good. A white flute. Not good. It's not good. So we're gonna do this regardless of what you say, regardless of how long it takes or anything. We're gonna do this today. Please don't tell me that's the department store. Is this the warehouse? Yeah.
Ha! Hello. I'll catch you waiting. I will use the storage key I've obtained from the Team Galactic. Yes, it's open. I will go on ahead, my friend. Do not expose yourself to danger.
Earthblade. Again, we could get judgment to be an earth. We could get a ground type judgment from that. Alright. So I have no idea where I'm going in this hideout. Like I say, it has been so long. Since I... Special key is needed. Wait, Luca, why don't you just give me the storage key? You just give it to me. Let's see what levels they are in here. Because... Chatot said that we needed to level up. And... I'm fully inclined to believe her, because I know the levels of the gym were quite high. But I like a challenge. I do like a challenge. Yeah, we're going to use Assurance. I don't think I've ever used Assurance on this playthrough. But it did its work there. So the levels were high in the gym. They were high in the gym. I agree. Training up's probably a good idea. But I'm running on a bit of a tight schedule today. And I need to...
We just got a lucky egg.
Okay, I'm gonna give it to Pingu for the moment, because the problem we've got here is that we're training up two Pokemon in Pingu and Mantis. It will help with me with grinding later on, but if I can find an opportunity to bring Pingu in against a fairly weak rock ground type or ground type or something, I will do. And I'll lucky plate it up. Spender, no good against a spender. But sucker punch me. Did a lot. Critical hit. No need. Buzz off, Spinder. Can't believe we just got a lucky egg. That's going to make my grinding so much easier. It's going to make it so much easier. I'm sure Chatot will be happy with that one as well. And a Stunky. A Stunky Dart type yet? Obviously it's poison. I was going to go into Oni, but I'm a little bit worried that he is actually a Dart type already. So I'm going to stay in with Birdie Pie. I mean, there we are. Aerial Ace is doing a lot of damage to anything, to be honest. Birdie Pie is he's putting in work. I know he's... It's not a replacement for Fear. I miss Fear. Chatot misses Fear. But he's trying as Birdie Pie. He really is trying. He's trying to do his best. We've got to heal that poison up. I bought loads of full heals as well, didn't I, last episode, so that's alright. That is alright. Oh, hi. I'm a Team Galactic member, but I don't even have a Pokemon. I'm the gruntiest of the grunts. He still doesn't even know how the warp panels connect. Oh, warp panels are the bane of my existence. Who do you think you are, desecrating the halls of our HQ? Lazy Marshall sent out to Glalie. We are not staying in against a Glalie. We are not. Not a chance. Yeah, I'm going to Ashes. It's the only thing that we can really go into. If we'd evolved Ice Fang, I would have murdered Birdie Pie. Just point that out. I would have murdered him. If we'd have actually evolved Pingu by now, I would definitely have used Empoleon there to quad resist the ice type move. Take a little while to train up Mantis. See, like I said, this is going to be quite a bitty episode because I don't really know where I'm going. I really don't. What's in this one? Before I battle that trainer. Never know, there might be a good item knocking around. Oh, there is an item there.
Hey now, our HQ is state-of-the-art facility. A snot-nosed kid like, or to keep your dirty hands to yourself.
Snot-nosed? Snot-nosed? I think I'm okay.
Bayleaf.
I'm sure Chatot's glad that she's not doing this. An X defend. Wow, okay. Might live this now. Yeah. But it's still a two shot, and I'm sure I outspeed this Bayleaf. Yeah, I do. For Mantis. Just need it to get... Ooh, agility. Just need it to get high enough that it's usable. I didn't see what ability Mantis had. Get rid of Focus Energy. I never use Focus Energy. Yeah, I might use agility. Probably not. We could do with a bug type move on there. A bug and a good steel type move. That'd be nice. I've not gotten any volume here. No volume at all. Magical leaf. I really want to know what else Shaman's going to learn, because he's had the same moveset for a long time now, and two of those moves are TMs, taught by TM. So, I really want to know. I know he doesn't learn Seed Flare until, like, stupid late. We got a Root Fossil! We can go in. And we've got Fly. We could do that in seconds. We could actually do that in seconds. That's how we're ending this episode. We're going to go and get a new fossil. We found the Galactic Key. Cool. Cool. I didn't even know that that was the way you're supposed to go. Had no idea. Right, bug bite. Can anybody learn bug bite? Everybody can learn bug bite. Okay, here we go then. First things first. First thing is first. Scizor. Scizor. Gen. 4. Learn set. Does Scizor learn bug bite, or what's the other good one? X Scizor. By level up. Gen 4. X Scizor level 41. Actually, he's got a really good learn set. So we're gonna get Metal Claw at 21. Fury Cut at 25, Slash 29, Razor Wind 33, Iron Defense 37, Exes are 41, Knight Slash 45, Iron Head 53. Oh, there's double hit in there as well, and Sword Stance. So we've got a good move set there. We don't need to teach him Bug Bite. So who can learn it that I want to learn it? Bug Bite is a good move. Decent move. What's Bug strong against? Not a whole lot. Dark types. It'd allow only to hit dark types. But then it's a fighting type. He would anyway if he had a fighting type move. What else is Bug strong against? Psychic? It'd allow only to hit psychic type moves, but I'm not sending him in against psychics. Nah. We don't really need it. Shame, because it's a good move. Well, it's a decent move. It's not amazing, but it's decent. Oh yeah, what was him? It's probably Swarm. Yeah, Swarm. We're modest natured as well, which that stinks. That's a bad nature for a Scizor. Alright, so we're about where we started. Which means we can just run through here. This music is crazy, by the way. It is all over the place. I'm actually going to carry on. Because we got this guy who was over here. So we'll go up these stairs. And I can battle this guy and go through up these stairs. I'm like this close to getting my promotion to commander. I'll impress the great boss by making you my newest trophy. You knock yourself out, man. Knock yourself out. Go for it, Lazy Max. Got a shield on. Alright. Respectable. Respectable. It certainly can't take you on with Birdie Pie. Birdie Pie is doing nothing to you. Is shield on Port Rock? I feel like it is. It's special. I don't think it's going to do much. No. So this is going to be neutral if he's Port Rock. Endured the hit, though. He endured the hit. Oh. really. Sorry. I'm speeding up through the endure nonsense. Stupid shield on. Late teen. Let's send in a panker. We are staying in. I could have gone back after the baby pie, I suppose. Could have gone back out into Birdie Pie. It would have saved Ashes from getting too strong, but it's only a Panker. It ain't going to give too much experience, is it? 250. And a Nidoran male. So you were planning on adding me to your trophy cabinet here. How's that gone for you? This team has been pretty poor. So this was my first ever time that I ever attempted to randomize something. So I think in the future, certainly for my own randomizers. Certainly for my own randomizers, I think I will include some extra rules so that these Pokemon are stronger when you get into the later portions of the game. So that you're not coming across, a Nidoran male at this point of the game, to be fair. It's a pretty good example. If there's an Ice type move coming, this was a mistake. Ryan, that's okay. That does nothing. I could have sky up a couple of them, couldn't I? That would have done more damage, I think. Still, Magical Leaf is stab. See you later, Lapras. Hedros is sticking on in there. Every time that Chatot tells me we've lost a Mon, I instantly go, not Hedros. Please not Hedros. And it's not Hedros. It's Hedros is just sticking on in there. I mean, I'm taking Hedros to the final with me. You were not facing my direction. You were not. Facing my direction. I do not care what you say. You weren't. I want to battle you anyway, but... Magnemite! I don't want to go into Ashes all the time, though. But we don't have Torterra anymore to do this, so we're going to Ashes. We don't have Torterra to earthquake this thing. Oh, I wouldn't have been surprised if Birdie Pie had been able to take it down. Well, saying that, everything's resisted, so maybe not. Maybe not. That's sending a Crawdorm. That's more like it. That's definitely more like it. And we have encountered no ground types in here. No ground types for me to bring out Pinga. I'd love to have a new grass type move on Hedros. I just want a new grass type move. Something stronger than Magical Leaf. It doesn't have to be crazy strong. But... Energy Ball. You know, Magical Leaf is good. But we didn't one-shot that Lapras. Well, we wouldn't have one-shotted the Lapras, I don't think, even with Energy Ball. Alright. This room looks important. TM85 bulk up. Not that important. That's all there is in here. Come all the way down this corridor for nothing. Team Galactic Credo. Everything belongs to Team Galactic. That's it. Well, I suppose good's the wrong word to use motto to live by, but it's a motto. Okay. So I guess that means we've got to take this right-hand warp panel. Oh, maybe not. Turn 46, uproar. So that means there's someone out, somewhere else in here. Somewhere else in here. Somewhere else using this warp panel. But I've already been down here. Oh no, wait, no. At least I know I've explored all of this now. Now I've actually got to go to the front, haven't I? Yeah, it all makes sense now. Well, whilst I'm out here, I might as well heal up, hadn't I? Might as well heal. Get back up to full. And then we can go charging into the second portion of this. I'm quite happy to just carry on until we finish this. I don't know what craziness happens. I really don't. I don't know platinum. So I'm kind of going for it, but without much knowledge as to where what I'm going for. Get in there. I genuinely thought that guy was like, "Hey, what?" He moved towards me as the door opened. Like, "Hey, you're not supposed to do that, man." Have fun scampering around our HQ, you sneaky. I have no idea what that said, but I won't tell you what I read. Your trailblazing will go out in a blaze of glory right now. I'm not going to tell you what I thought he said. You sneaky so-and-so. Right. Couple of things that we need on the team. We need Oni to learn a fighting type move. That is a given. We need that. We need Pingu to evolve. And we need Mantis training up. And then Mantis needs to learn a good steel type move and a good bug type move. What else do we need on the team? That's it, really. We need a good steel type move on Empoleon as well, on Pingu, when it evolves. I'm just going to... Psycho Cut actually does more. I'm going to use Oni for a bit. Try and train him up. That's neutral. Can we get a crit? We're all in the scope lens. We've got a high chance to crit with Psycho Cut. Yeah, thank you. Asking you shall receive. If you don't ask, you don't get. Level 21 for Mantis. Learning Metal Claw. Okay. This is it. This is an okay steel type move. Do we need full swipe? Really? We can catch things without full swipe. I may regret that. There's bound to be some sort of legendary encounter coming up in the near future that I will really wish that I hadn't done that for. Or Chatot will really wish that I hadn't done that. You should be tired out by now. I'm not. Not tired out at all. Well, in the middle of the day, come on. What do you take me for? If I had a fighting type move, this match would be easy. Can't really set up a sword. I can set up a sword stance now. I can set up a couple. Because he's surely not going to have sleep talk or snore. Surely not. Turn one. Gets plus four. And then nothing's standing in my way. Bye. That was a crit as well. I don't think the crit mattered. I really don't. Electric. You ain't that living either. I've just set up two sword stances to deal with the Sinnoh and Electric. Because that's the sort of trainer I am. Overkill. Don't static me. I thought it had then. That little pause of the I wouldn't have been pleased. Would not have been pleased. There's a report titled The Pokemon Statues of Eternia. Eterna. Pokemon Statue Plate Text Number 1 from Stolen Plate. The creation of Dialga, the Giver of Time, and in laughter there is tears, and likewise it is with time. For same time flows on, for it is the blessing of Dialga. The blue text has been extracted using a high-tech device made by the boss. Would you like to keep reading? Pokemon Statue Plate Number 2. The birth of Palkia, the creator of parallel dimensions, alive yet not alive, everything drifts in space. To arrive in the same universe, it's the blessing of Palkia. Okay. Let's try out these warp panels. Get these items. A mind plate. That's a I can get a psychic type judgment now. We've got so many plates. We've actually got a load of plates. Arceus, where are you? I kind of sound like Shady Penguin and the King Nappy. They were always searching for Arceus. Arceus, as they call him. I call him Arceus. I don't know, I've not watched the film with him in. So. I am currently watching through the TV series again. I'm watching the anime. Oh, you do want a battle? Oh, I thought you were just going to say something to me. Botanist Joe sent out a Shiftry. Shiftry's a little bit scary. I'll be honest. Used an X special. Now he's terrifying. Will I outspeed a Shiftry? I hope we wouldn't need to then. We do. Alright. We do. I was worried then. I was quite worried then. Shiftry gets good moves. He's a dark type. He gets some strong grass type moves. Not really sure he gets decent special moves. I thought he was a physical attacker with Shiftry, but he might be special. He gets extra sensory. I don't know about you, Lucky, but I don't want to take all these guys on.
Over here. This gathering of Team Galactic, what is the meaning of it?
Oh, we got a little bit of plot going on here.
Fellow members of Team Galactic,
I can't remember what voice I gave him before.
Hear me. My name, as I appear to you today, is Cyrus. In our world of ours is a cruel one. In a world, it is incomplete. In a word, it is incomplete. It has been, and always will be, a struggle to survive in this world. We humans and Pokemon are likewise incomplete. Because we are also lacking, we fight, we maim. It is ugly. I hate the incompleteness. That we are all incomplete, I hate it with my entire body and being. The world should be complete. The world must change. Then who will change it? Me, Cyrus, and Team Galactic, yes, all of you. Together we pored over myths and exposed their secrets. Together we captured legendary Pokemon, and now Team Galactic has obtained the energy to change the world. The power of dreams is within our grasp. Understand it, fellow members. My long-held dream world is on the verge of becoming reality. All those headed to Mount Coronet, and those who remain here. Though our missions may differ, our hearts beat as one. Let there be glory for Team Galactic.
Yeah, woo, woo, yeah, Master Cyrus is the greatest, woo, yeah.
Woo! So that was Cyrus, the boss of Team Galactic. Quite the performance, no? Mesmerizing for one only 27 years old. But to make another world for Team Galactic and none other is preposterous. So much that it makes my head spin. A new world? What is that? What is this incomplete world? Very well, to investigate such matters is the job of the International Police, of which I am a member in good stead. And it's my job, therefore. We shall part ways here. Take extra care, my friend. Okay.
That wasn't what I was expecting. I was expecting to be able to sleep. I really was expecting to just be able to sleep. We can. But yeah, I wasn't expecting to get that black belt. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Okay, we got a double battle here. Yeah, we don't want Ashes out front. Especially because Ashes hits with Lava Plume and hits everything. Or maybe I could put... Let's piggyback Pingu a bit.
Are you enjoying your unescorted, unauthorized, and unsettling tour of Team Galactic HQ?
Oh, actually, yeah, it's quite nice.
Hey, little trainer, you're a little famous rapper, Team Galactic. The honor has been issued to get a promotion if you get put down.
You ain't getting promoted today, my son. You ain't getting promoted today. Marowak and Aloudred. Wish I had close combat right now. I would close combat that Aloudred into another dimension. I'm gonna... Does Surf hit everything? Or does Surf only hit the opposite side? It hits everything. I'm gonna trust that Ice Punch will knock this Marowak down to below half so that Brian will do double damage and take it out. Or Oni can get a critical hit and kill the Marowak without any problem at all. That was a lucky egg boosted experience as well. Doubling up on crits. I might as well stay in. I'm going to Psycho Cut the Loudred. And I'm going to Bubble Beam this Diglett. We just got fissured! How unlucky can we be? It's a Diglett. Diglets are really fast. So that allows him to outspeed. We're a lower level than him. Because I think you need to be a lower level to connect with Fissure. That one's really painful. That one's really, really painful. That was literally Pingu's first fight. Unless Chatot used him last episode, which I don't think she did. and he gets fissured. I'm so sorry, Chatot. There was nothing I could do about that one. There was nothing I could do about that one. And Chatot said, like, when I killed H2O, Chatot said to me that she's killed enough water types. Well, that's my third water type that I've killed. I've only killed water types. Oh, man. That is a 30% chance to land Fissure. 30%. That's not fair. It's not fair. And he lived that. He shouldn't have lived that Psycho Cut. They intimidate from the Martiana. If I'd have just had Birdie Pie out. Oh, I think you deserve a promotion, man. I'm sad. I'm really sad about that. I was looking forward to using... I was looking forward to using Pingu so much. And... it wasn't just taken away from us. It was violently taken away from us. It's like... that was violent. Oh, I didn't deserve that. He did not deserve that. And this item's an ice heal. Would you hide an ice heal behind a box like that? Power Bracer. That was violent. Violently denied. That's what this episode is going to be called. Violently denied. Ugh. And now we've got to take on this guy. Are we ready? We're about as ready as we're going to be, aren't we?
So you've come. You heard my speech, I take it. A big lie, of course. It's true insofar as my intention is to create a new world. But that world isn't for the likes of Team Galactic. I seek an entirely new world solely for myself. If not, it can never be the same. It can never be the complete and perfect world. You see, my minions of Team Galactic, you yourself must know that they are uniformly useless and incomplete. I know why you're here. I can sense it in you. It's about Yuxi, Mespress, and Azalf, correct? You want to save them. I no longer have any need for them. I am finished with them. Your heart aches to save them. Go right ahead. I couldn't care less. It'll save me the trouble of disposing of them. But I must say, you are a remarkable specimen. Those Pokemon have nothing to do with you, do they? But still you came to rescue them out of pity. Such pitiful, useless emotions. It's illogical and irrational. Pity and compassion are products of the weak and faulty human heart. You were compelled to come here by such vacuous sentimentality. I will make you regret paying heed to your heart.
Whoa. That's a really cool speech. I like Cyrus. Sailor Jill. Sends out Carvana. I mean, unfortunately, Carvana actually deals with Oni pretty well. But he doesn't deal with Hedros. Oh, I'm still rocked by that Fissure. Completely rocked by it. I can't. I've got to message Chatot and ask her for updates to the layout and things. Oh, Lord. Still, we've only lost three Pokemon. I've only lost three Pokemon. Oh, a Ho-Oh! Oh, yeah! Who would have been good against a Ho-Oh? I kind of want to go into Ashes and just resist. Do you think Hedgerows could live a Sacred Fire or a Fire Blast and get up a Leech Seed? I don't. I'm going into Ashes. However, if this is like the Ho-Oh that we faced a couple of episodes ago, or last, it might have been last episode but that I recorded. 46. He's got Fire Blast, Ghost, Safeguard and Recover. That was a crit. So yeah, Fire Blast is obviously going to do the most damage. Out of them. Which means he should go for Fire Blast 5 times in a row. But he may recover. He might recover now. I want to get him. We actually outspeeded Rock Conklin Flinch, if I remember rightly. So we actually could do with, yeah, using up all of his Fire Blast PP, and then we can bring Hedgerows in and get a Leech Seed off. Just to help whittle this thing down. He does just over half with two Fire Blasts, so a crit would probably take us out. Because we've had Shell Bell recovery in that as well. There's the third Fire Blast. We'll get through five. He doesn't crit. So we can go for another Rock Climb. I'm trying for flinches. I might as well try for flinches as well whilst I'm here. I'm sure it's flinches that we can do. There's number four. And heal again. And then he should Fire Blast once more. And then we're in business. He recovers. Okay. If he Fire Blasts once more. Because we looked up Lugia last episode as well. And he didn't get Aeroblast until. Oh, he confuses. Well, that's nice. It's got Sunny Day. Alright, so now does Sunny Day mean that my Fire-type moves will do more than Rock Climb? He's got really high special defense. I know from our Pokemon Gold playthrough, he's got really high special defense. Use this Fire Blast. Thank you. Sunny Day is not going to... He's not going to boost it enough. That's a crit. I've got to heal, and then switch. He's not going to have any PP ups on his Fire Blast. So he's got Sunny Day, Recover. He must have Gust. Swift. That's even better, actually. Because that's not super effective against Hedgerows. This Ho-Oh can't touch us now. Can't do anything. So bring in Hedgerows. Just because Leech Seed damage will help. The alternative is bring in Oni. And Sword Stance. To get past this huge defense. But no, we'll bring in Hedgerows. And I'm going to start Charge Beaming. After the Leech Seed lands. How much does Swift do? 122. to 95, so he does 27. And we're going to heal most of this off with Leech Seed and Leftovers. So he can't touch us. He can't do anything. We actually heal more than he deals. About to say, please get the special attack raise. Because I need to deal a lot more damage than that. I might have to go into Oni and Sarsaur's Dancing though, because that's just not enough damage. I can't get through recover. I can't get through recover with that amount of charge beam. Unless I get another raise here. I need another rise here. This episode is going to go on for longer than an hour, by the way. I hope you're okay with that. It's got citrus as well. This Ho-Oh is just ridiculous. I'm still reeling from that fissure. Honestly, I really am. Fissure Diglett. I'm actually going to message Chatot and say we've lost him onto a Diglett. And that's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to say. Leech Seed is not going to be enough to take it out. He's got a chance to recover now. If he recovers, I'm not going to be happy. I don't want to speed up because this is an important battle, but... That's even worse than a recover. That's even worse. We're at plus 3 though. If we can get another attack raise, special attack raise here. Okay. Plus 4. It basically means that whatever the next... Oh, we're out of charge beams. Damn pressure. Oh, I've got a sky up cut now. I've done all of these increases in my special attack and I've got a sky up cut now. Does nothing. I should have sword stance. I should have gone into Oni and started sword stancing. Magical Leaf is quad resisted, so this is going to do nothing as well. Even with my even at plus 4, that was a crit. Okay, provided he doesn't recover, I take him out this turn. He's got a not hit recover though, or an item. He uses Swift. Okay, I should take him out now. Magical Leaf's going to do next to nothing, but Leech Seed will take him out. Okay, we got another crit. Okay, great stuff. Oh man. That was a tricky battle. That was a tricky battle. And he's got an Aerodactyl. Like, the one mon. Aerodactyl destroys our team. Aerodactyl absolutely destroys our team. I've got to stay in and hope that Magical Leaf is enough. We're at plus 4. We can take a takedown, no problem. We're at plus 4 with this Magical Leaf. It's not quite enough. And he misses the takedown. Okay. Whew. That was a long battle. That was a very long battle. Mantis wants to learn Fury Cutter. No, we don't want Fury Cutter.
Interesting, and quite curious. I see, you are indeed strong. And the basis of your power is compassion toward Pokémon. How wasteful. Such emotions are but mere illusions. And like all illusions, they fade over time until death banishes them forever. That is why I have abandoned all emotions and useless sentimentality. But that doesn't matter. I doubt you will ever understand my position. That said, I recognize you are strong and courageous to come alone. This is your reward.
We gotta give him a Master Ball.
A Master Ball is the ultimate Pokeball. It will unfailingly catch any Pokemon in the wild, but it is not anything I require. Unlike you trainers, I do not make Pokemon my friends or partners. Unlike other Team Galactic members, I don't use Pokemon as tools. Instead, I make the power of Pokemon my own. If you wish to save the Pokemon from the lakes, take the warp panel ahead. I am off to Mount Coronet. I will ascend the mountains to its peak where destiny awaits me. It is there that I will create my new world.
We might as well head in here and... This... They said head on ahead. Use the wall panel ahead. That is the wall panel ahead. He obviously means this one. A Chesto Berry. Are these guys going to want a battle? No, he's moving. He's not going to want a battle. Feel about off about what we did. The experiment went too far. I'm not sure I can stomach what Master Cyrus plans. Ugh, feels too sickened to say anything. But that thing we made, what is it going to be used for? Uxie is sealed inside. It appears to be suffering with his eyes squeezed shut. With racking shudders. What's Mesprit? How much pain is Mesprit in? With its tail twitching, Mesprit's not in much pain. Who's Charon? Fire! That's Pokemon on the lakes! Where do you suppose they would go? What are you trying to say? Nothing, pain, no heed. Our new world isn't overly interesting, what of it? Cyrus is right, then Team Galactic will rule our new world! That's when it'll be interesting. I just to enjoy his sweets. I surely hope that our visionary Cyrus realizes his dream. I will look forward to what our beloved leader has planned on top Mount Coronet. Gramps, our boss can do without your kind of moral support. Is that it? Do I have to talk to Saturn? You came all the way here just to save some Pokemon. Though it's nothing new, I can't say I understand our boss. Why would he let a kid like you come and go freely? We, Team Galactic, take all that we need and eliminate what we do not. But anyway, you've taken the trouble to come. Let me welcome you. Consider it payback for your insulting me at the lake. Oh, we got another battle! This is a really long episode, guys, and I really apologize for that, but... I want to get this done. Psycho Cut this snow run. There's nothing snow run can do to me. Thank you. Because I just thought sheer cold is what snow run can do to me. A Phoebus. I only can stay in on a Phoebus. Oh. After that high battle against the Hoenn, we've got a snow run to the Phoebus here. What other intimidating Pokemon have you got? Porygon Z. Okay, that's actually a little bit scary. I'm going to Psycho Cut. Uses Embargo. I can't use items anymore. Does that affect my Lucky Egg? Unsure. Magnet Rise. Okay. Nothing to be worried about with this Porygon. Does it outspeed us, though, which is a little bit concerning. I thought Oni was fast. Citrus doesn't take it out of range to kill, though, so... How's your Discharge going to do? Northy. Was a lot of experience for Oni. You're tough, kid. I still pity the likes of you. What makes you so tough? Fine, do whatever you want with those three Pokemon. Press the button on that machine to set them free. Just teleport away. Our boss crafted a red chain from the crystals he took from the three Pokemon. That red chain is what's needed to shackle something on Mount Coronet. It also apparently needed for creating something. That's all I know. Who knows what he's planning to do up there? Who knows? Who knows? Right. I know this episode is really long, but it might as well be a few minutes longer. Because what we have not done in this episode is get any form of encounter. So I'm pretty sure Chatot's going to have to once again... Pingu! Once again, enjoy Mount Coronet. But, we're going to go to Orberg City. And I'm going to get this fossil resurrected. It's in the mining museum, isn't it? Hello, hello, how are you? I study Pokemon fossils, me, right here and now. You were gone too long, you kept us waiting. Unacceptable! This is your... Oh, we must have had a root fossil before. This is your Kingdra. We must have had a root fossil before. So we've got another Kingdra. well... You know what? We got H2O 2.0. Okay. I am going to have to do some grinding after this. Regardless. So... Yeah, I guess... I'm not gonna put Kingdra on the team. Let's give a nickname to Kingdra, yeah. Okay, so we've had Sheldon. We've had H2O. It's a male seahorse. I kinda wanna call it something to do with the fact that male seahorses get pregnant. I don't know. To be honest, I'm not even sure if we should be using this Kingdra. But I want to call it like something like resurrection or something. I don't know. I don't know. There's not a lot. I don't know. I don't know what I can call it. We call it jet stream. Yeah, we haven't got any other fossils. But yeah, so we got Jetstream, the Kingdra. We once again got a Kingdra. Oh dear, it's adamant nature. Right, okay. I'm gonna in between episodes. I'm gonna have to end this episode off here because it's gone far too long. In between episodes, I will train up, and if Jetstream makes it onto the team, then you'll see it over on Chatty Chatot's channel. And I will have trained it up to equal the rest of the team. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this episode. And I will see you next time. Stay brave, guys.